to you from the Old Testament. Actually, one of my favorite stories in the Old Testament that comes from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 5, verses 1 through 5. And this story may be familiar to you, but it may not. And I think it's a great direction for us as we worship the Lord today. And that is this. This is what it says. When the Philistines captured the Ark of God, they brought it from Ebenezer to Ashdod. And the Philistines took the Ark of God and they brought it into the house of Dagon. Dagon was their god. And set it up beside the idol Dagon. And when the people of Ashdod rose early the next day, behold, Dagon had fallen face downward on the ground before the Ark of the Lord. So they took the idol Dagon and put him back in his place. But when they rose early on the next morning, behold, Dagon had fallen downward on the ground before the Ark of the Lord. And the head of Dagon and both his hands were lying cut off on the threshold, and only the trunk of Dagon was left to him. This is why the priests of Dagon and all who enter the house of Dagon do not tread on the threshold of Dagon and Ashdod to this day. 1 Samuel 5, 1 through 5. It's helpful for us today that we realize that as we worship the Lord, as we exalt him, and as he leads us and teaches us, all of those idols, all of those things that vie for our attention fall face down in his presence. That there's no idol stronger than him. There's no name above his name. And so that's what we're going to do today. We're going to exalt him and worship him, knowing that every other thing falls face forward in honor of our God and King. So we want you to join us as we worship.